5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engines running.
If you were able to look into the perspective of someone who believed we never landed on the moon, you will see this. A fake mission that was a mere simulation, recorded for TV and staged in Hawaii, with a script written by Stanley Kubrick. The astronauts, the shuttle, and the American flag planted on the top of the moon were all a hoax.
Here, we can see you coming down the ladder now. Click.
The origin of this conspiracy came from one man, Bill Casing. Born in Chicago in 1922, a World War II vet, he hopped from job to job as a salesman, an insurance claim examiner, and a cabinet maker until landing a job at NASA. Surprisingly, the conspiracy started off as a joke, but that joke clearly rolled into something much bigger. In an interview, he even mentioned that it would be a spoof or a satire.
The reason I believe that NASA and the government faked the moon landing was basically it was technically impossible to do it.
But he continued to write and fall deeper down the rabbit hole. At one point, he said that he found himself wondering whether he was working on a hoax or whether he was actually becoming a technical detective. Little by little, the evidence seemed to build in the favor of the Apollo project itself being a gigantic hoax. Building up the credibility he had after he worked at NASA, 0.017% was the number he always cited for the chance of a successful lunar mission, which by the way, he never provided any evidence or math for. He called the Apollo mission the Apollo Simulation Project, aka ASP, where the lunar landing was staged in a TV-like set. There were three main key evidence that he included. One, the fact that there were no visible stars in the original photograph, the unsurvivable radiation known as the Van Allen belt surrounding Earth, and finally, the lack of blast crater underneath the lunar lander. But this has obviously been debunked numerous times. For one, NASA used high shutter cameras to capture the moon landing to make sure the pictures weren't completely blinding from the moon's light, which explained the lack of stars in the background. Second, the astronauts on the mission didn't float around in their space shuttle passing the Van Allen belt. This is the Van Allen belt. As you can see, if you stay within the inner radiation of the belt, then you are at risk of very high radiation. There is also an outer radiation belt. Most satellites actually stay within the frontier of the inner radiation. In order to pass safely, they firewalk through the belt, aka speeding as fast as humanly possible to avoid radiation poisoning. Those conspiracy theorists were thinking that for astronauts not to leave the Earth and cross the radiation belt, it's impossible that they did it without getting radiation. But they were actually going at a really, really, really fast speed. The escape velocity of Apollo 11 was 24,500 miles per hour. Wow. If you like the video so far, please hit subscribe. And lastly, the lack of crater on the moon is just pure physics. Since the moon gravity is 1/6 of the Earth, a smaller, softer landing was used to slow the shuttle down.
Take it slow.
Nonetheless, despite the constant debunking of moon conspiracy theories for over the last 53 years, the conspiracies community grows. So I was just looking at evidence or some polls that show what percentage of Americans actually still believe that we didn't actually land on the moon. The result was pretty staggering. Let me show you. So look at this. So it says that 6% of Americans in 1995 and 1999 still believe at this stage. And about 5% have no opinion as of 1999 when that poll was taken by Gallup. So I just did the math. So there's about 329 million people in the US today. And if the poll still hold and then there's 6% of Americans that still believe we didn't actually land it on the moon, that's about 1.9 million Americans today that believe that we never landed on the moon. So close to 2 million people. That's crazy. Here on YouTube, I'm not the only one dunking on moon conspiracies. There are so many other channels who put up similar videos and other channels who are dedicated to proving it was all a hoax.
The time has come when you must admit this is a hoax.
But how did such an outlandish conspiracy get so popular? Coincidentally, Hollywood movie Capricorn 1 premiered in 1978, featuring the infamous O.J. Simpson. This film tells the story of a young journalist investigating a government hoax of a staged astronaut landing on Mars. Pretty soon after Capricorn 1, dozens of moon landing conspiracy media started popping up. At the end of the day, there was money to be made, and the moon landing hoax was the gift that kept on giving.
With them, it's all about money.
Despite the growing community of conspiracies, NASA planned to go to the moon again with their Artemis mission. The Artemis mission aimed to put the first woman and first person of color on the moon.
Hi, I'm Christina Cook.
Stephanie Wilson.
My name is Johnny Kim.
This is what we will do.
Let's go.
and then awfully sends humans to Mars. Will the second moon landing face the same skepticism in an age of social media and smartphone? Only time will tell. Maybe this time we'll get a tweet from the moon or even see them dancing on TikTok. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.